Andy here. Now the Dungeons & Dragons Adventures in the Forgotten Realms is officially released. Today is the official release date, Friday, July 23rd. We don't have time to waste and we need to start discussing and speculate on the next set, the Return to Innistrad, the Fall Standard set. But wait, this fall will not get the usual one set, but two Innistrad set, which will be released within approximately 1 month apart. Midnight Hunt in September and Crimson Vow in November, and both sets will be standard legal. Wait for your wallet to cry. To fuel the speculations and to start discussing these two sets, it's time for my Innistrad Midnight Hunt and Crimson Vow predictions. But first, let's roll the dice and take a look at my Dungeons & Dragons Adventures in the Forgotten Realm prediction score. My first prediction was Dragons, 10 out of 10, not that of a difficult prediction for a Dungeons & Dragons set. Second prediction, Dice Roll, 10 out of 10. I predicted that Dungeons & Dragons will feature cards that will have certain abilities depending on your dice roll score. Third prediction, Adventure Party and Companion, 0 out of 10. I said that the previous set mechanics, Adventure Party and Companion, will feature in Dungeons & Dragons, but it didn't happen. Fourth prediction, Heroes, 10 out of 10. I predicted that this set will feature legendary creature Heroes of the RPG. Fifth prediction, Heroes Equipment, 6 out of 10. I predicted a cycle of powerful equipments. Yes, there are some good artifact equipment, but still Embercleave is the most powerful equipment currently in Standard. Sixth prediction, Dungeons, 7 out of 10. I said that as for Dragons, Dungeons will also feature in this set. What I got wrong is that I said Dungeons will be the land cycle. Seventh prediction, 5 Realms, 0 out of 10. I predicted that because the set is called Adventures in the Forgotten Realms, there will be 5 Realms to close the cycle of 6 Haven Colleges. Got that one wrong. 8th prediction, Sarkhan Vol, 0 out of 10. I said that because the Planeswalker Sarkhan Vol has ties to Dragons, he will return. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. 9th and last prediction was the Dungeon Master, 0 out of 10. Totally out of track. Total score 43 out of 90. I had better predictions. Anyway, let's start my predictions for Innistrad Midnight Hunt and Innistrad Crimson Vow. My first prediction, Werewolves versus Vampires. We already know that each set will focus on a particular creature type. Midnight Hunt on Werewolves and Crimson Vow on Vampires. And it's not a surprise that both creatures type don't like each other. Therefore, I predict that both sets will focus on the ongoing struggle between Werewolves and Vampires from their own point of view. Second prediction, the return of the original double face cards. Innistrad was the first set to have double face cards, and even though at first reception was poor, once released these cards became very successful. The latest sets released, Zendikar Rising, Kaldheim and Strixhaven, featured a different hybrid of double face cards called Model, which you can cast or play only one side of the card, and once on the battlefield you cannot transform them back. Original Innistrad double face cards, once on the battlefield you can transform them as many times as you can, and that's what made them so popular. So for these two sets I predict new transform double face cards. Third prediction, no Eldrazi. Shadows over Innistrad and especially Eldritch Moon main focus was the Eldrazi, which in my opinion should have stayed on the plane of Zendikar, but Nahiri came back with a vengeance, and what a vengeance, Emrakul. In the end of Eldritch Moon, Emrakul, with some diplomacy, was imprisoned in the Silver Moon. Having said that, I predict that in both sets there will be no Eldrazi, but only a reference or a mention. The influence of Emrakul is still there. Fourth prediction, back to the original Innistrad theme. Innistrad is well known to be the first horror gothic set, and that's why this was a very successful set. Vampires, werewolves, humans, zombies, spirits, etc, etc, all contributed to that dark atmosphere. Unfortunately, the second Innistrad block, Shadows and Eldritch, diverted from that theme towards the Eldrazi, and that's why initial reception of this block wasn't that good. Therefore, I predict that in both sets will go back to the original Innistrad horror gothic theme. Fifth prediction, the wedding. Crimson Vow will be all about the biggest vampire wedding in Innistrad history. But who will be the bride and who will be the groom? I predict that Olivia Volderen will be the bride and Soren Markov the groom. Soren needs to regain some standing amongst the vampire society, especially following his defeat by the hands of Nahiri. Also, he needs to make a move to stabilize his role on Innistrad and continue his self-given role as protector. Olivia Volderen, on the other hand, has other reasons for the marriage, namely to finally join the most powerful vampire families on Innistrad. At this stage, I wouldn't be surprised if werewolves will crush this wedding or humans will be the banquet. Sixth prediction, the return of Soren and Arlen. From the leaks of the packages of Innocent Midnight Hunt, we already know that some familiar planeswalker will feature in these two sets. Teferi and Vren and Sex are clearly visible. Therefore, I predict that two more native Innocent planeswalkers will be returning. These are Arlen Kor, the werewolf, and Sonin Markov, the vampire. Let's see if Sonin will be really the groom. 7th prediction, returning and new mechanics. We already discussed that original double face cards can feature again in these two sets, including the transform mechanic, which contrary to the model double face cards, you can transform a permanent once on the battlefield, and transform will be a returning mechanic. Therefore, I predict that for these two sets, we'll have returning mechanics from the two previous innocent blocks and also new mechanics. I can also risk saying that vampires could have different mechanics for the major vampire families. 8th prediction, Talia. Did you really thought that an Innistrad block can be released without Talia? With Avazin undone, Liliana on Sixhaven teaching potions, Grisselbrand gone, Garruk playing with gingerbreads, Talia is one of the few original and beloved characters left on Innistrad. Therefore, I predict that in these two sets, we'll get a new powerful Talia card, maybe this time at Mythic Rarity. 9th and last prediction, not a happy ending. When we speak about weddings, it's usually something nice and positive. We congratulate the bride and the groom for a start of a life together, but not on Innistrad, and especially when vampires and werewolves are involved. My prediction here that similar to a Game of Thrones wedding, I don't think this will be a happy wedding. Yes, biggest wedding in Innistrad history or even in Magic the Gathering history, but surely not the happiest one. Leave me a comment below what are your expectations or predictions for these two new Innistrad sets, and as always, don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more and more interesting videos about Magic the Gathering and the collectible world.